interesting matchup, Bruce. Shane Crawford picking up Jeff Farmer.
That's a beauty, isn't it? Crawford on Farmer. Farmer at left half forward for the D's. They go to the left of screen, and Salmon and White is going to be a pivotal clash here. Trelevin out after it. Viney, the first kick of the match, and Farmer and Crawford are caught underneath it. And Farmer's read it beautifully, hooks it back right to the goal square, and front spot to Nutz. He was able to walk his way in front of Graham. They had a battle, and that too is going to be a terrific duel.
It certainly is, Bruce. Mark Graham just asking the question to the umpire, then he thought he was unfairly moved out of the contest. It was just strength from Neitz. He was able to hold his ground, push Graham aside, assume front position, and should finish it off with a relatively easy shot for goal.
3-6 so far this year. Robbo talked about his inaccuracy, but he really should get the first goal of the match. He's put it through. That's the start the D's wanted. Remember back to that final against Adelaide in the first week of September where he and Farmer just dominated.
Very critical clearance from the centre by Todd Viney, and he's a very important
Came from Hay. Smith's kick not good. Very poor, in fact. See Ingerson on hands and knees. Gee, Shanahan was good. Getting it across to Walsh. Walsh's little one into the centre. White yet again. Caught up this time by Hay. Was a reasonable tackle. Handball by Phoebe. Matthew to Johnston. Johnston at half forward. Looking. Gives it to Farmer. Farmer centering balls of beauty. Gives Neitz a chance. Wonderful skills, Farmer. Vision. And then the strength of Neitz to finish it off.
Well, we certainly said it was going to be an exciting duel. Farmer and Crawford. And that's a, well, no mean feat considering the form that Mark Graham has been in.
Should go. Oh, there's the angle. Not much at all, is it? We'll follow it through. He's drifting it. He's missed, I think. That's a bad miss. We told you a moment ago he'd kick 3-6. Get rid of it. Rigoni. Schwartz was clever. Used Tingo. Tingo with pace now. Centering ball. Woden in the target. It's a good kick. Got him.
Looking to chime in if he could. Forgot about his man. It was a bit of a wobbly kick. And by the time he turned around and realised it wasn't going to Schwartz and Neitz and Graham, why Woden had the mark.
And some great shepherding too by Farmer then on Tingo then, Jason.
Well, Neitz missed one from about this spot. By Woden, similar angle. That looks a good kick. He's got it through. It's a goal. Here's the injury. By the way, it's a crowed free kick, but there's the injury to Seacamp. And at this...
It was his own man, Tingo, that ran into it.
Bang. Right on the top of the head. So let's hope that it's only a temporary thing and that he's fitting well and maybe even able to play some part.
The game of football's hard enough without your mate running into you, isn't it? Poor old Marcus Seacamp off the ground on the stretch.
Craig Trelevin, certainly contact with the head and certainly a warranted free kick.
Kicking here, and Paul Salmon's made a couple of errors in this match. Leon Chelly, that's his trademark, running through the centre. Long kick to fall forward. Neitz attacks. Clever to Farmer. Farmer quickly onto the boot. And the Whiz has kicked it. Instinctive. Can't really teach anyone to do what he just did.
No, you're spot on, Bruce. A little bit unlucky for Shane Crawford. I think all the Hawthorn defenders are particularly worried about David Neitz. He came streaming out. A couple of players, Crawford in particular, left his man to try and cut the ball off. And unfortunately what happened was he didn't get there in time. The ball gets tapped out to the side. And of course it's Crawford's man, Farmer, who just...
Foot kick. Oh, well done. Gee, it looked like a training drill, didn't it? Bringing the ball through the middle of the ground. And the big man, Jeff White, the skillful left foot pass, has given Neitz his third chance in about 12 or 13 minutes of play in the first term. One goal, one against his name. Kicking from about 30 metres, so distance, no problem. Let's watch how he drops the ball this time. He gets it long and just offline. So disappointing has created the chance here for Rigoni. He feeds it wide for Todd Viney. Gee, their blocking of the Hawthorn attempt at tacklers has been quite sensational, Melbourne. What about the in and unders here? Very close to the boundary line and skillfully done by the Demons to keep it alive. Eventually, not forward. Gee, this kick-in is, well, very poor. Tingay goes back here to Robertson. Robertson, flying shot at goal by Russell Robertson, misses to the left, and the Demons left lamenting a couple of good chances.
Coming in crudely there was Barlow. Not much harm in all of that. And the umpires are quick to come in. But patchy opening term. Don't think the Demons, I don't think Neil Danaher would be absolutely thrilled with what he's seen, but they've got a good lead. Start of the second quarter of the Melbourne Cricket Ground, Friday night footy. Hawthorn to the left of screen. Melbourne to the main scoreboard end, and the D's have made a good start. Salmon went early there to try and stop the white run. Viney was able to get through too easily and then kicks the ball to the forward pocket. Crawford belts it away and then Johnston belted it back. Graham towards the line.
Having an impact around the centre bounce. Hand pass to Woe Woden. Woe Woden's kick beautifully marked by Nix. He started positively. On the other hand, Mark Graham is struggling.
Just in relation to that early jump by White, Robbo, if he had made contact with Paul Salmon, I believe the umpire would have paid a free kick to Salmon. But
he nearly jumped clean over his head.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. If Paul had made it so as there was some contact, I think he would have got a free kick.
Well, White, certainly a jumping jack at the centre bounces, but we're watching David Neitz going for goal number two. And he continues.
One goal, three now. Right?
Ingerson to Longmuir. Demons to go down the ground. Phoebe with the ball. He's going to run through centre wing. That's Matthew.
And kicks the ball long to half forward. Well done at the bat by McKay, but he's given a free kick away. It was a great contest.
Yeah, that did look a bit tough. If the player's prime objective is to spoil, then that's legitimate. And that did look like his prime objective was simply to spoil.
Anthony McDonald with the free kick. He pops it to the goal square, needs to use his body, and he's got it again against Graham. He just stood toe-to-toe with him that time, decided not to lead.
..in the air for so long, and no one else to come and force a contest, and in a congested area to take a chest mark, is poor. Just see how the Melbourne defenders there kept the... kept the Hawthorn defenders away from the contest and allowed Neitz a one-on-one.
Well, surely he'll go here. He has.
Leon Charlie White's on his own and should kick a goal. Jeff White goes and misses.
Gee, if he had kicked that, I would have said there is no justice.
Colicker in his first year looks a good type. He's an athlete. Kick to the pocket to Schwartz. Got him. Gee, there's Vandenberg and Schwartz again.
Trent Crowe hopelessly lost there, and Schwartz made a lead. He took his eye off the plate. Crawford tried to step in and put the lead off, but he kept going, and in the end, he was 10 yards clear.
Schwartz taking it on the chest, and then Vandenberg. Now, he is a thumping kick, Schwartz, and he's got the distance and missed. So the D's, that was a difficult shot.
And Robertson quick enough.
He's a handy player, this fellow. I haven't seen a whole lot of him, but he's just 20. Averages a goal a match, and he's come on for Schwartz a couple of times in this match, and he's been useful.
Good centre and kick back into the attacking part of the ground. And you just wonder if the Demons have become a little...
Take a good big kick. He's outside 50. Angle about 45 degrees. Not quite going to make it. And Farmer's taken a chest mark and plays on. And the Wizard has kicked the goal. Well, he conjures things from not a lot.
And if I was Shane Crawford, I would think he has every right to feel rather angry with Brendan Crummell. Crummell, the taller player, went down to the goal line. He took up the one-on-one duel with Farmer, who's probably 3 or 4 inches shorter than him, and yet he allowed Farmer to work him under the ball. Crawford stayed down like a good small player should do, and he gets punished because his man ends up kicking the goal.
Ten goals out of 44 this season so far.
So he turned the other way, and that's a fantastic tackle to really put them under pressure.
And Paul Salmon gone down the full four there where Mark Graves...
Longmuir, gee, that was interesting. Leg up to protect himself, and then Chick copped him round the ear. But Longmuir, who's been pretty impressive, baby face, but tough as they come, I'd think. He's got the mark. Inside to Woe Woden. And that's it at half-time. Gee, it was a good second quarter of footy. There were some wonderful contests. This match is very much at where we thought it might be at half-time. Anybody's game. Because going into the match, it was a line ball. I know Melbourne were the bookmakers' favourites, but Hawthorn had 1-2, lost 1, and the D's are 1-2, and it was 5 versus 12. and there's not much in this at the long half. Break. About to commence at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Friday night footy. The Demons go to the left. Salmon going early against White to try and stop that run. It's been effective. Matthew Phoebe, Viney, well done. It was a terrific sidestep by the veteran captain. Little chip was okay to White, who was prolific early. Back to Viney. Viney trying to straighten. Graham, who looks like he's playing on a wing, just stopped him in his tracks. Front spot was Johnson, had a good fly. Crawford's little toe poke didn't go far. Woden's handball was outstanding. Ragone's kick for goals, a beauty. What a start for the Demons. They've got the first. After half time, it was a terrific handball. And Ragone finished it off.
And virtually an exact replica of the start of the game. The perfect start for the Demons. The ball was scrambled out. The hand pass came from Woden. Now, Ragone not noted as being strong on his left side of the body, but that's a fantastic kick.
He turned to Longmuir, quickly onto the skipper. Away goes Todd Viney from 50 metres. Gets good distance, not quite the accuracy he was searching for. Through for a behind.
Chisholm with some toe here, and then coming in Barlow. It's a good race, isn't it? Barlow's done particularly well. Then toe pokes it only as far as Longmuir. He's had his head taken off. It was bad luck. I think Lekas might have done the tackle. Longmuir, who
good was type. Lekas. Good type, this Troy Longmuir.
Yeah, Jason spoke off camera in the commercial break at halftime about him, and he likes him too, Longmuir. As Viney, who's got a lot of it, gets to Matthew Phoebe.
20 possessions for Viney.
Phoebe kicks to half forward. Is it going to get as far as Neitz? Crawford looked as if Farmer might have held on to him. Back to Neitz. Neitz is so strong. Just fends off the tackler. Kicks to Schwartz. Got him. Bit of power there from Neitz. Just brushed his man aside like he was swatting a fly. Schwartz went to go. And I think Taimon might have been called. And he's been called to go back over the mark. Now he improves his angle. Goes for goal. Not a bad kick. Right there. Ray Woden over the top. And this has been a problem for the Hawks tonight. We saw Farmer take really an uncontested mark at the other end of the second quarter. Something Richard Taylor to go away. He's missed it. He'll be disappointed. Do you think Neil Danaher does that deliberately occasionally?
Have a shot here. Up towards half forward. And he will do just that. Right to the goal line. It has gone over the head. Walsh did well to get a hand to it and force it through for a behind. Good passage of play there for the Hawks. And the man right in the middle of it, Daniel Harford, nearly goaling.
Hasn't Peter Walsh been impressive?
He's Chicks going to fly. Gee, that was a mark.
Oh, dear.
It was just Chicks. Nobody else's. Smith Hamble missed everything. Quick kick away by the Demons in defence. Von Longmuir gets to Woden. Woden at centre wing. Here's a go. Leoncelli.
Very good kick too. Leoncelli's got no one in front of him. And he goes long. He gets terrific distance. And he's banged it home for the Demons.
That looked like an uncontested mark, and Daniel Chick was the bloke that had the very, very firm grab of it, but not paid.
Well, a magnificent kick by Leoncelli. He's played Johnston's kick into the pocket is good. Hard to displace the Ox from in front. Trent Crowe has played well, but the Ox has the chance to kick Melbourne's eighth goal.
Just managed to push off Crowe just before he made the lead. Got him on the back foot. Gained a few paces break and a good pass from Johnson.
Another player who has overcome adversity. And what a kick. That is quite magnificent, David Schwartz.
Mitchell's Farmer back to Crawford. Schwartz puts a real tackle on Crawford. And the little big man is good enough to stand tall as he always does, out of play.
Gee, don't mind that, Jason, that spirit there between David Schwartz and Shane Crawford.
He's fantastic, Shane Crawford. He really got hammered in the tackle. And great to see the Ox just pick him up at the end and say, well done. But I'm going to make you earn it. Well done.
That's fair enough. And I think the spirit of the game is fantastic. We have another one. He kicks it well outside the defensive 50.
Oh!
Jumping Jeff White, you ripper. Away to Phoebe. Phoebe's kick inside the forward 50. Back it goes to Johnson. In goes Travis Johnson. No, can't get the screw under the kick. Kicks it further away from goal, from where it came. And it's out of bounds about 40 metres from the Melbourne goal. But what about Jeff White's leap? Magnificent stuff. Watch this. up and over Brendan Crummell, had to sit and was 10 out of 10 for that performance. Boundary throw in, we'll look at it from another angle.
Towards the wing.
Woden, who's been an important player. His kick goes inside the forward 50, and Schwartz has judged it a little better than Trent Crowe.
All he has to do is repeat the effort, and this would really get them fired up if he could do it again.
Getting close to 150 career goals, David Schwartz. Have a look at this.
If you don't mind.
What a bomb! That is David Schwartz doing the same tonight.
And Robbo, doesn't it just highlight the difference between the two sides at this stage? We had Neitz in the first half. Now it's Schwartz providing a key option up forward. Hawthorn has to battle a lot harder to get their goals.
Big kick, isn't it, from a big man. Three knee reconstruction.
Gets it back
to Stephen Phoebe. Stephen Phoebe hooks. It's coming back. Not enough. It's a behind.
Oh, chance going CG. Goes short, player on his own. It's McDonald, 50 metres from goal. Anthony McDonald can kick a goal here for Melbourne. Close to three quarters.
Behind this side, he wins a lot of hard balls in the middle and has really set up this opportunity for Anthony McDonald.
Well, he's a good kicker of the football. And this is a lovely kick. It's gone all the way. It's a goal. Beautiful kick by Anthony McDonald.
Found the man with the space and he didn't let him down. It's great field kicking for goal.
They have Schwartz. This quarter, they've been fantastic.
There's the siren as Crummell ran onto it. Did the umpire hear it?
He did, Robbo.
I think he might have. It was a goal kicked by Crummell, but it won't be allowed because the siren sounded just a fleeting second before Crummell had kicked the ball. Three-quarter time here at the MCG Friday night footy. Stephen Tingay, as usual, tough at the footy. The coach, still with a quarter to go. The opposition coach, down to Lectury's
first
play.
Goal here, vital. If Melbourne get it, it's going to make it pretty tough for the Hawks. But the thing about the Hawks, they've shown a lot of resilience under Ken Judge, and they will keep going. Robren getting his first run, so and first touch. Belts it in the direction of Holland. Terrific Mark Walsh. What a good young player this fellow is. He's had some great moments. Woden bangs it back in. Front spot, nice big fly, Schwartz. Could you think of anyone better?
No,
he's
certainly in distance, but doesn't fortune favour the Brave? It was a bit of a flat, floating punt. He just decided to charge at the ball. He leapt up in the air and met it at full speed and took a fantastic mark. And, well, we know he's in range. Can he kick straight again?
50 metres out. It's coming back. It's long and it's strong and it's a goal. He is the man for the big man.
Well, the big man wearing the Guernsey number 5 for the D's just puts the big hand up in the air. Congratulations.
Got some numbers. Crowe flies in there. Comes back to Hassel, who's had his hands on it a bit. Poor handball. Leon Chilli's good enough. The hook back kick to full forward. It won't be a goal. Who can take the mark? Well done, Lekas, because Neitz was lurking. Right made a valiant attempt. Hawthorn have got numbers. Crowe. Hay had an airy. A mistake. Farmer high tackle. Inexperience maybe from the Hawks here, Crowe and Hay.
Yeah, Jeff Farmer certainly didn't make it.
Particularly when you're trying to tackle the smaller players, the natural reaction is to duck the head a little bit or drop a little bit at the knees, and you've really got to go at the hips.
Goes for his third goal. He's been beaten tonight by Crawford, but that's a good return. It just went away, didn't it? It was going.
This is Crawford with a footy. McCabe should be penalised. And that was a bad error right within scoring distance. Luke, I don't think there's much you can say to the umpire.
Oh, look, he's just lifted the footy, Robbo, and once you lift it like that, then you're in real trouble. So certainly the free kick was warranted. But in the heat of the battle and with the ball the way it is, you'd love to be a little more lenient with the players. But the instruction given to the umpires is that if they lift it like that, he's gone.
That just looked such an odd thing to do, and I think that was brought on by the pressure of the game. He had fought well against a bigger opponent in Neitz that brought the ball to the ground, and all of a sudden he wanted to get rid of it, and he just scooped it through the legs. It's a definite free kick. I've got no problems with that, but it just seemed so out of the blue to do something like that.
McDonald with the football. He's already kicked one. It was an absolute bomb in the third term from outside 50 metres. So we know that he can kick a goal. Holland trying to relieve that blood situation. McDonald goes for goal. He's kicked it. Demons by six.
Robin drop mark was costly, wasn't
kicks
it?
From goal. We've got 2 minutes left. And who's going to have the good fortune in the last couple of minutes? White still jumping, leaping, and getting a big fist to it. Farmer. Hey, Farmer! In goes Jeffrey Farmer. He made a blue. Oh, would have kicked it, I think. Oh, dear me. It's going to be locked up by the Hawks. And Jeffrey Farmer was home and hosed.
This game has had everything. Last time he didn't give the ball out. He tried to kick it himself. He got a bit of a spray for it. This time, he just tried to handball it over the top. Michael Colicker took a fantastic look. He just took the gamble. I'll jump up and smother it.
Schwartz does well. I think that's out of bounds. Well, there were centimetres in that too, folks.
And he's trying to handball it through for a point. Yeah, there, Schwartz. He couldn't get it boot to ball. So he thought, I'll handball it through for a point.
Well, who came in and knocked it? It was fantastic defence. Because
bird.
Those Hawthorn boys, they're obviously aware. Sneak a point, they lose the game. Boundary throw in, right in front of the Melbourne goal. It's got to be balled up now. Taylor, chance for Farmer. Still there for Melbourne. A chance for the D's. No. Those gallant Hawks to Finn Bradley. There is 1.5 minutes left. The odds are in favour of the Demons. It's only metres from their goal.
It's like a rugby match just for the moment, isn't it? They're trying to force it over the line.
Someone's got to go back and stand on the goal line because they'll try and punch the ball through.
Throw up. The Demons build it. They've got it through from behind. There is time, though. Hawthorn will get one good crack at this. Melbourne lead by a point. Crawford, he has to come back. I think the umpire was still waving the flag.
Yes, that's right, Chris.
Of course, the Hawks have no idea. The players have no idea how long there is to go. The clock says 31 minutes 50. That's a long quarter. There is time. Barlow from Hassel. Well, this is the last big play you would think. Great mark, Chip. Yeah. Sensational.
Got to get it down quick.
Magnificent mark. Loads up. Doesn't quite get it to centre half forward. Tingay on the pass.
Got to go up. Joel Smith just was waiting down, but no one was there to contest the mark.
Leoncelli's got it. The Demons will wax it here. They'll try and soak it up. They lead by a point.
I think they're home. They'll hang on to it now. They'll kick backwards if they need to.
Hawks have to man up, have to force something.
There it is.
Leoncelli back.
That's got him home.
McDonald back.
Oh, he would have missed a point.
Phoebe all across the line. Just to Walsh. That was close. Walsh away. And Melbourne has won it. The Demons by a point.